life cycle. So generally from this binary fission, the precystic otherwise daughter individuals may be formed. So this also mature. So this also mature and shows impact on the digestive system of the man. Okay. So here tropozoid. So this is develops into tropozoid. Tropozoid binary fission. After repeated binary fissions, trophozoites converted into precystic stage. Precystic stage converted into cystic stage. Cystic stage develops four nuclei. That is called as tetranucleate cyst. So tetranucleate cyst discharged by the fecal matter of the infected person. Within the fecal matter, it will live for 10 days. Otherwise, if it is not transferred to new man, then it will be died. So if it is transferred by the contaminated food and water, it enters into the alimentary canal, intestine of the man, and by the effect of trypsin enzyme, that cyst is dissolved. So the dissolving of cyst is called as exudation. That form is called as metacystic form. The nucleus of the metacystic undergoes two divisions. So they forms 8 nuclei. Each nucleus receives some sort of cytoplasm, and by rupturing that wall, the 8 daughter entamoebulae or metacystic trophozoites comes outside. They matures into the adult. Okay, so this is the life cycle of plasma entamoeba histolytica. Okay, let us see pathogenesis. Sir, if you take the pathogenesis, let's see pathogenesis. Okay, see here, by releasing the histolysin enzyme, they damage mucosa and submucosa. And they damages the tissue, and the blood mucus comes outside. So they causes ulcers there. Okay. So when the blood and tissue is coming, the parasite feeds upon the blood cells, tissue debris, fragments and bacteria which present in the intestine. Okay. So here, generally, this bacteria ingested or RBC ingested food vacuoles, by that the trophozoites can be identified. So this is called as primary amoebiosis. Primary amoebiosis takes place only in the intestine. Okay. So that is why when the tissue is damaged, along with the fecal matter, the damaged tissue, blood, mucus comes outside. So this is called as amoebiosis. That is called as amoebiosis. Or amoebic dysentery. So here, generally, amoebic dysentery, amoebiosis means the fecal matter with the blood and mucus, or stool with the blood and mucus, is called as amoebiosis or amoebic dysentery. So this is primary amoebiosis. Next, some of the individuals, even though they have tetranucleate cysts, they will not exhibit any symptoms. So some of the individuals do not exhibit any symptoms, but they are able to transfer the tetranucleate cyst to the one host to another host. Means they helps in transfer, but they do not exhibit any symptoms. Such individuals are called as asymptomatic cyst passers. Okay, so what are the asymptomatic cyst passers? The individuals with tetranucleate cyst do not exhibit any symptoms, but they transfer disease from one individual to the another individual. That is called as asymptomatic cyst passers. Okay, now next, see, sometimes secondary amoebiosis also seen. Sometimes what is seen? Secondary amoebiosis also seen. So if you take the secondary amoebiosis, sir, here sometimes these trophozoites are transferred to some other organs, and especially sometimes they goes to the liver, So this is called as liver abscesses. They enters into the liver and there they causes ulcerations. There they causes ulceration. That is called as liver abscesses. Liver abscesses. So liver abscesses means liver is damaged. Other than the liver, some vital organs are also damaged, especially lungs, brain, kidneys. Okay, na? So liver, lungs, next brain, kidney, some vital organs also damaged due to the infection of the trophozoite. So this is called as secondary amebiosis. Primary amebiosis, the mucosa, submucosa damaged by the histolysin, the blood and debris comes outside, that is ingested by the tissue. So then that is called as primary amebiosis, that is amoebic dysentery or amebiosis. So through the fecal matter, blood and mucus comes outside. Okay, so this is about the pathogenicity. Next, if you see prevention. Next, if you see prevention. Sir, here majorly the pathogenic stage is, infective stage is what? Tetranucleate cyst. So this tetranucleate cyst is the infective stage. So if you are able to escape from the infection by the tetranucleate cyst, you will be healthy, you will be escaped from the disease. So first thing is, generally first we have to wash food substances, means especially vegetables and fruits. So we have to wash vegetables and fruits before eating carefully. That is the thing we have to do. Use boiled and filter waters. Use boiled and filter water. Next, eco toilet should be used. So open defecation must be banned, because when we do open defecation, tetranucleate cysts are remaining in the environment. Easily they will be transferred to our food substances. So we have to use toilets, eco toilets. Open defecation must be banned. So we have to wash vegetables and fruits before eating as well as cooking. Next, we have to wash our hands before eating and after defecation. So next, outside food should not be allowed. So these are the preventive measures which can be taken from the prevention of entamoeba, histolytica as well as amebiosis disease.